see if it's loose enough to pull up out of the hole. One thing important about these meter box, whenever you go into a meter box to cut it off or to examine it, whatever, make sure that you look at it very close before you start to stick your hands down in there, because there have been times where we found snakes in the meter box and spiders, the brown recluses. This is a good spot for them to hide out, so just be cautious and make sure that you don't see them before you stick your hand down in there. Okay, we just lift the top part off. This is going to make it lighter to lift the remaining of the meter box out of the hole. Okay, let me remove a little more of this dirt from around this box and these. Right now you can see, actually see the one of the water service lines going to the meter box. And there's another one right there, right side by side, one for each house. And usually when I start getting a little closer to the water service lines, it's a little, you want to be real careful. So usually I kind of put the shovel away, and I usually would use a small spade, or like you seen what I just did, I used my hand to kind of push some of the dirt away. Here's a little small garden spade. I usually keep one of these in the truck when I go do jobs, just for this particular reason, so that when I get down to areas where I feel it's kind of delicate and we want to be careful, and we just want to do some light digging around this to prevent any damage to the water service as of now, because there's water on there. So, but we're going to replace it, of course. But in the meantime, we want to keep it as dry as we can. And looking at the two water line services going into the meter box, you can see that the each line, most plumbers would know that those fittings on the end, okay, this is a part that's it's been repaired before, and they just threw the old part down there. But anyway, you can see the dresser couplings, that part has been replaced with.